In this video, I will present an example of linear programming application, portfolio selection. This example falls under financial applications. Portfolio selection problems involve situations in which a financial manager must select specific investments, such as stocks and options, from a variety of investment alternatives. The objective function for portfolio selection problems is usually maximization of expected return or minimization of risks. The constraints usually take the form of restrictions on the type of permissible investments, state laws, company policies, maximum permissible risks, and so on. In this example, there are four stocks A, B, C, and D. The management has stipulated the following investment guidelines. The annual rate of return for the portfolio must be at least 9%. No one stock can account for more than 50% of the total dollar investment. This appears to be for diversification purposes. Please stop the video and see if you can formulate a linear programming model for this example. What are the decision variables, objective function, and constraints? I have provided some hints here by underlining some of the information here. Are you able to complete step 1, define the decision variables, state the objective, and state the constraints? Let's work on this problem step by step. First, let's start with defining the decision variables. The management has to decide how to invest in four stocks. One trick that helped me to identify the decision variable is try to come out with one possible strategy. It does not have to be the optimal strategy at this moment. And then we move on to a more generic strategy that will be helpful for defining the variables. One possible strategy here is to invest in all stocks equally. So that's going to be $50,000 in stocks A, B, C, and D. We notice that we used the four variables here, A, B, C, and D. They represent a dollar amount invested in each stock. So these four variables are indeed our decision variables. Moving on to the objective function, we try to minimize the portfolio risk. Could we express the total risk for our generic investment? Well, we know that for stock A, the risk per dollar is 10 cents. If we do invest in a dollar amount in stock A, the risk from investing A should be A multiplied by 10.1 multiplied by A. Similarly, we can calculate the risk for other stocks as well. For example, B multiplied by 7.07, C multiplied by 0.05, and D multiplied by 0.8. We now sum up all of them and obtain our total portfolio risk. The objective here is to minimize the total risk, so we use mean function in lingo. Be sure to end your line with a semicolon. There are several constraints in this example. For example, we only have $200,000 of funds to invest, meaning that the total sum of dollar amount A, B, C, D is 200K. So this is going to be our first constraint. The management would like to have an annual rate of return of at least 9%. Let's calculate the annual rate of return for our portfolio. To do that, we first have to calculate the annual rate of return for each stock. For example, the return for A is 12%, 0.12 here as you can see. For B is 8%, C is 6%, D is 10%. This is only the dollar return. We have to convert it to the rate of return or percentage return. Well, we invested a total of 200K, so the rate of return is just a dollar return divided by 200K. Okay, so total dollar return is 0.12 multiplied by A, 0.08 multiplied by B, and so on and so forth. So this is total dollar return. To convert it to rate of return, we're going to divide it by 200,000. That's our total dollar amount invested in this portfolio. So we can, their ratio is going to be annual rate of return, and we do want this to be at least 9%. So the ratio has to be at least 0.09. We can express it in lingo as shown in here as well. The last set of constraint is for diversification purposes. No one stock can account for more than 50% of the total dollar invested. Well, we have $200,000 invested. 50% of that is going to be $100,000. We just need to require A, the dollar amount to be invested in A, to be less than 100K, B less than 100K, C less than 100K, and D less than 100K. Okay, so this is going to be the last set of constraint. We have successfully completed step one. Now, in step two, let's input all the codes in Lingo. Note that there is usually more than one way of defining the decision variables. For example, in this example, I used A, B, C, D to represent the dollar amount invested in A, B, C, D respectively. If you define your decision variables A, B, C, D, or any other variable names as number of shares purchased, then the coefficients in the objective function and constraints need to be adjusted accordingly as well. So this is my definition for the decision variables, and this is objective function. We have three sets of constraints, as you can see. Here is the printout from Lingo. The optimal solution is to invest $33,333 in A, $66,666 in C, and $100K in D, and we should not invest in B at all. When the management does that, they should expect the lowest portfolio risk of $14,666. I hope you find this example useful in helping you understand how to set up and solve linear programming. This also concludes this video.